welcome to an exciting afternoon of varsity girls softball here on CPHS 6. I'm Emily Desmond. And this afternoon we have the Port Huron Big Reds versus the Port Huron Northern Huskies. And that's going to be a slap. And she's going to be safe at first. Now up to the plate, we have Jennifer Reed. And the first ball, first pitch is a strike. And the steal at second is good. Oh, and two on the batter. And that's going to be a slap hit to the pitcher. They're going to get the out at first, advance the runner to third. This will bring Courtney Baker to the plate. The first pitch is high for a ball. You got Brianne Cates at third for the Big Reds. The second pitch is swung on and fouled. It's a breezy day here at Northern. Means the pitcher's going to have a hard time throwing the ball. They got to keep the ball low or the wind will carry. And that's going to be a strike. Count's going to be 1-2. And that ball's going to be hit right back to the pitcher. And they're going to get the out at home. Two outs now for the Huskies. This will bring up Megan Murphy. Big Reds now with the runner on first. And that pitch is going to be a strike. And that swung on and missed. 0-2 now on Murphy. And that's going to be a ball on the outside. And that's going to be out at second. And that's going to do it for the top. And as we go into the bottom of the first, Huskies are up to bat. First up is number 2, Sarah Hall. And that's going to be a slap right to the pitcher, and that's going to be an out. This will bring Allie Prang to the plate. The first pitch is hit on, and it will hit the grass. And Prang is going to be safe at first. This will bring up Chelsea Cohen. And that's a pop-up foul. And that's going to be hit to center field, bobbled by the center fielder, and that's going to advance the runners. Northern now with the girl on second and first. This brings up Morgan Thompson. And that's going to be hit, and they'll get the out at third. Two outs now for the Big Reds. Katie Lawson now at the plate, and she slaps it into center field, and that's going to score one. It'll hold up the runner at third. Alex Ainsworth now at the plate. Huskies have a runner at second and third, two outs. And that's going to be popped up in the infield, caught by the shortstop. And that's going to do it for the first inning. Huskies up 1-0 against the Big Reds. And as we head into the top of the second, up to bat for the Big Reds, we have Megan Murphy. Katie Lawson still at the mound for the Huskies. And that's going to be chopped to the third baseman. And it will be, she will be safe at first. Now to the plate, we have Taylor Cook. And that ball's gonna run up the third baseline and it's gonna be fair. And Megan Murphy will score. The game is now tied 1-1. Taylor Cook will get the triple and an RBI. This brings Jade Roan to the plate for the Big Reds. Pitch was high for a ball. Big Reds with a man on third. And that's going to be cut and foul. First baseman Gabby Lemire was unable to get to it. And that pitch is going to be low for a ball. Another chopper hit foul. this be a ground ball hit to the shortstop. And they will get the out at home. This brings up Kate Coaster to the plate. Big Reds now have a man on first. And that's going to be hit between second base. And that'll be a single for Katie Nitzke. Bases are now loaded for the Big Reds. This will bring up their leadoff hitter, Brianne Cates. The first pitch will be a strike. Second pitch is swung on and missed. 0-2 the count. And that'll be a ball outside. 1-2. And that's going to be hit right back to the pitcher. And she'll get the forced out at home. Pitch is swung on and missed. Base is still loaded for the Big Reds. And that's going to be a strike right up the middle. And that's going to be hit to the third baseman. And she will get the out at third. And at the top of the second, as we end the top of the second, score tied 1-1 as we go into the bottom of the second. And as we head into the bottom of the second, this brings Marissa Williams to the plate for the Huskies. First pitch is high for a ball. Second pitch is swung on and missed. 1-1 now on Williams. Katie Nitzke at the mound for the Big Reds. And that's going to be a pop-up to the third baseman. And that's going to be the first out. Gabby Lemire now at the plate for the Huskies. Go hard, go hard, go hard, go hard. And that ball's going to go between the feet of the second baseman. Lemire will be safe at first. Emily Brooks now at the plate. First pitch is high for a ball. And the bunt is no good. 1-1 now on Brooks. And that chopper is going to be hit foul. 2-2 now on Brooks. Huskies still have a man on first. And that's going to be popped up and foul. And that's going to do it for the bottom of the second. Quick 1-2-3 out. And after the bottom of the second, score still tied 1-1 as we go into the top of the third. 1-2 the count now on Reed. And that's going to be a tapper up the third baseline. And Reed will be safe at first. This will bring up Courtney Baker. First pitch swung on and missed. Reed still at first base. And that's going to be a line drive hit to the second baseman. And that'll make two outs. This will bring Megan Murphy to the plate. And that's going to be hit up the third baseline, and the ump will call it foul. Big Reds have no one on base due to the line drive to second. The runner on first ran right into it, it seemed like. And that pitch will be hit foul. That pitch was high for a ball. 1-2 the count now on Murphy. That's going to be slapped foul. Excellent pitching here by Katie Lawson. when the third inning and there still hasn't been a walk. And that's going to be popped up high. And Lawson will get it for the third out. And as we go into the bottom of the third, the score's still tied 1-1. And as we go into the bottom of the third, Sarah Hall is up to the plate for the Huskies. First pitch is swung on and missed. Katie Mietzke still on the mound for the Big Reds. And the slap was no good. 0-2 now on Hall. And that'll be hit right up the middle to the center fielder. And Hall will be safe at first for the single. Next to the plate, we have Allie Prang. And the bunt is no good. 0-1 the count on Prang. And her second attempt at the bunt is good. She'll be safe at first. And this will advance Hall to third base. The first baseman, Taylor Cook, unable to get the ball at first. Huskies now with a girl on first and third with no outs.
Come on, RBI time. Drive it, get some grass.
Chelsea Cohen is now to the plate for the Huskies. Big Reds can't be happy with that play. A routine play, an easy bunt, and they were unable to get the out at first. First pitch is high for a ball. And that's going to be a hit to the shortstop. She'll get the out at second and score the runner at third. And that's going to be a hard hit ball to the left field. And that's going to score another run. And Morgan Thompson will have the double for the Huskies. And that's going to be a ball on Katie Lawson. Huskies have a man at second. And that's going to be a chopper hit to the shortstop. They'll get the out at first. And advance Thompson to third. Alex Ainsworth now at the plate. The first pitch is good for a strike. And it's going to be a slow chopper to the shortstop. And that's going to be the third out. And after three, the Port Huron Northern Huskies lead 3-1 over the Port Huron Big Reds. And as we head into the top of the fourth, Taylor Cook up to the plate for the Big Reds. First pitch slapped and hit to the shortstop. And that's going to be the first out. In the past three at-bats here, they've all been hit to the shortstop. Now we have Jade Roan at the plate. First pitch is a strike. Lawson doing an excellent job pitching today, coming out with a first ball strike ball. Won the count now on Roan. Big Reds down by two as we're in the top of the fourth. And that's going to be hit on to center field, and that's going to be caught by number two, Sarah Hall. And that's going to be two quick outs here. Now Kate Koister to the plate. And the changeup will be low for a ball. Second pitch up high for a ball. 2-0 the count on Koister. And that's going to be a pop-up, and it'll be caught by the shortstop. And that's going to bring us to the bottom of the fourth. Huskies still up 3-1 over the Port Huron Big Reds. And as we head into the bottom of the fourth, Marissa Williams now at the plate. First pitch is hit to the third baseman. And that's going to be an out at first. Katie Nitzke still pitching for the Big Reds. This will bring Gabby Lemire to the plate for the Huskies. First pitch is low for a ball. Huskies are still up by two. Again, the ball is going to be low. And that's going to be a tapper hit foul. Huskies with one out. This will be a full count on Lemire. The catcher's going to drop it, but the throw down to first is good. Two outs now for the Huskies. This brings Emily Brooks to the plate. First pitch is hit back up to the pitcher. And Brooks will be safe at first. This brings Sarah Hall to the plate. Huskies now with the girl on first. And her slap is no good. 0-1 the count. Her second slap goes foul, 0-2 now on Hall. And that's going to be low for a ball. And Brooks unable to steal, but able to get back to first safely. This could be another ball low. And that slap is good, right back to the pitcher. And that will be an out at first. Huskies unable to score this inning, but they're still up 3-1 over the Big Reds. And as we head into the top of the fifth, Big Reds down by 2. This will bring Katie Nitzke to the plate. And the first pitch by Lawson is a ball. Second pitch is up high for a ball. And that's going to be right at the knees for a strike. 2-1 the count on Nitzke. And that's going to be hit right back up at the pitcher. And that's going to be one down for the Big Reds. Katie Sanderson now at the plate for the Big Reds. First pitch is outside for a ball. Second pitch is right up the middle for a strike. 1-1 the count on Sanderson. And that's going to be another strike. 1-2 the count. Big Reds with no base runners. That's going to be a chopper. Caught by the first baseman, Gabby Lemire, and that's two down now for the Big Reds. Yeah. This brings up the lead-up hitter, Brianne Cates. That's going to be hit to the second baseman, but she drops it. Cates will be safe at first. With two outs, this brings up Jennifer Reed. Her bunt is no good. Her second attempt at a bunt is good. And that'll be the out at first. Big Red's unable to score this inning. Huskies still up 3-1 against the Big Reds. And as we head into the bottom of the fifth, Allie Prang up to the plate.
Nice cut one. Sit back and drive it.
Her first hit up and foul. Her second pitch also foul. 0-2 on Prang. Katie Nitzke still at the mound for the Big Reds. And that's going to be hit right back to the pitcher. And that's going to be one out. Chelsea Cohen at the plate for the Huskies. And that's going to be hit to their right fielder. And it's going to be caught by Katie Sanderson. That's two down now for the Huskies. This brings Morgan Thompson up to the plate. Thompson hits the ball to the shortstop. And that's going to be a 1-2-3 inning. Huskies still have their 3-1 lead over the Big Reds as we go into the top of the sixth. And as we head into the top of the sixth, Courtney Baker at the plate for the Big Reds. First pitch is low for a ball. Katie Lawson pitching an excellent game for the Huskies. Second hit to the right fielder. And Baker will be safe at first. This will bring Megan Murphy to the plate. Big Reds with a girl on first, no outs. First pitch is hit foul. This is the last chance for the Big Reds to score some runs. And that's going to be popped up and into the bleachers. Another chopper goes foul. And that's going to be up to the right. The right fielder unable to catch it. Ump will call it foul. The Huskies very lucky on that call. They could have potentially scored the big red runner. That pitch is going to be inside for a ball. That pitch is going to be up high for a ball. And that's going to be hit foul up the third baseline. The Big Reds with no outs, runner on first. And that's going to be hit up the middle. Baker will get the single. This will bring up Taylor Cook. Still no outs for the Big Reds. Got a runner on first and second, down by two. And that pitch is going to be just outside for a ball. And that's going to be hit to the shortstop. They'll get the out at first. This will advance the runner to third, as well as second. Jade Roan now at the plate for the Big Reds. And that pitch will be inside for a ball. Big Reds have runners on second and third, and they're down by two. Excellent save there by the catcher. And that's going to be hit to the second baseman, and they'll get the out at first. And the Big Reds will score. The Big Reds now with two down. A runner on third. This brings up Katie Coaster. Pitch is swung on and missed. And that's going to be hit to the shortstop. Coaster will be safe at first and scores the run from third, tying up the game, 3-3. This brings Katie Nitzke to the plate. That ball will be hit foul. Still two outs. Big Red with the runner on first. And that'll be up the middle for a strike. One and one. catches up high for a ball. That's going to be outside for a ball. And that's going to be hit to the third baseman. And they'll get the out at first. Big Reds able to tie the score 3-3 as we go into the bottom of the sixth. And as we head into the bottom of the sixth, Katie Lawson now up to the plate for the Huskies. First pitch is swung on up the middle, bobbled by the shortstop, and Lawson will be safe at first. Alex Ainsworth now at the plate. First pitch is bunted. There will be an out at first, and they'll advance the runner to second. Marissa Williams now at the plate for the Huskies. Be swung and hit the third baseline, and that'll be a foul. And the changeup will be high. Pitch swung on and missed. 1-2 the count on Williams. Huskies have one out with the runner on second. And that's when he popped up. The catcher and third baseman unable to get the ball. That's going to be bounced off the shortstop's arm. She's able to block it. Huskies still with one out. Now they have base runners on first and second. This brings Gabby Lemire to the plate for the Huskies. First pitch is up and fouled. And 2 the count now on Lemire. Runners still at first and second for the Huskies with one out. And that's popped up high to the center fielder. She will catch it. Lawson able to tag up at second. Lemire will advance the runners to second and third. Emily Brooks now to the plate for the Huskies. Two outs. They'll be hit up the third baseline. Huskies unable to score. And the score still remains 3-3 as we go into the top of the seventh. As we head into the top of the seventh, number one, Katie Sanderson up to the plate for the Big Reds. Katie Lawson still the pitcher for the Huskies. First pitch is swung on and missed. And she'll drop the bunt, bobbled by the third baseman. And Sanderson will be safe at first. The leadoff hitter, Brianna Cates, at the plate. The slap, unable to get there by the pitcher. Cates will be safe at first. Big Reds now have runners at first and second with no outs. This brings up Jennifer Reed. And her slap is popped up and foul. And her attempt at the bunt went foul. 0-2 on Reed. That pitch will be tipped foul. 0-2, still the count on Reed. Big Reds still have runners at first and second with no outs. And that ball is gonna be popped up and hit to the right fielder. She's unable to get there in time. Big Reds are able to score a run. Jennifer Reed with a double and an RBI. This will bring Courtney Baker to the plate. First pitch is hit and fouled. Ball will be hit to the shortstop. They'll get the out at first. The Big Reds will score another run. Big Reds now up by two. This brings Megan Murphy to the plate. Big Reds have one out and a runner on third. First pitch is high for a ball. Second pitch low for a ball. You can see that Lawson's getting a little frustrated here. Nothing you can do about the errors made on the field. That pitch is swung on and missed. 2-1 the count on Murphy. That'll be a ball up high, 3-1. And that's going to be the first walk for Lawson. Taylor Cook now at the plate for the Big Reds. Big Reds with one out have a runner on first and third. The pitch will be low for a ball. And Murphy will get the steal at second. Big Reds now have a runner on second and third. And that's going to be popped up. And no one unable to get it. Big Red's still only one out. Pitch right up the middle for a strike. And that's going to be popped up into shallow right. It's going to be dropped by the second baseman. And that's going to score another run for the Big Reds. Big Reds now with a 3-point lead. Jade Roan now at the plate for the Big Reds. Pitches up the middle for a strike. Big Reds with runners on first and third. And that's going to be a chopper to center field. And Roan will get the RBI. Big Reds now up by four. Kate Coaster now at the plate for the Big Reds. Runners on first and second with one out. Pitch will be low for a ball. That's going to be hit foul. And that's going to be popped up to left field. It'll be caught. That's two outs now for the Big Reds. Excellent catch there by Carly Miller out in left field. The first pitch is going to be low for a ball on Katie Nitzke. Second pitch right in there for a strike, 1-1. Two outs with a runner on first and second. One and two now on Nitzke. And that's going to be popped up and out. pitch is going to be low for a ball. And that's going to be popped up to center field. And it's going to be caught. And that's going to do it for the top of the seventh. Big Reds leading 7-3 over the Port Huron Northern Huskies as we go into the bottom of the seventh. And as we head into the bottom of the seventh, we started off with Sarah Hall for the Huskies. First pitch is low for a ball. Katie Nitzke still pitching for the Big Reds. Second pitch low for a ball. 0-2 the count. Swung on and missed. 2-1 now on Sarah Hall. Huskies down by 4. And the umpire is going to call a dead ball. It was out of the box. She was out of the box, and that's going to be an out for the Huskies. First pitch is in low for a ball. One and one, the count now on Allie Prong. And that's going to be hit into shallow center. And Prang will be safe at first. This brings Chelsea Cohen to the plate. Huskies with one down and runner on first. First pitch is in there for a strike. Second pitch is low for a ball, 1-1 on Cohen. That pitch is going to be low for a ball. Another low pitch for a ball. 3-1 the count on Cohen. Huskies have one out with a runner on first. And that's going to be a slapper hit to the shortstop. The Huskies will be out at second. She overran the bag. Was unable to get back to the bag on time. Two down for the Huskies, runner on first. This brings up Morgan Thompson. First pitch is low for a ball. And that's going to be hit between the third baseman and shortstop into left field. That's going to draw the single. This brings Katie Lawson to the plate with two outs. Runners on first and second. And that's going to be hit to the second baseman, and they will get the routine out at first. And that's going to do it for the game. The Port Huron Big Reds win 7-3 over the Port Huron Northern Huskies. This has been Emily Desmond with CPHS6. Good night.
I was thinking about all the stuff. Yeah. maybe some computers and stuff like that.
And I would maybe buy some chairs for people.
For some chairs? Well, good.
More chairs.
More chairs. All right, that's all right. Well, keep up the good work in school, okay? Next time I see you, make sure you say, hi, Mr. Kendall. Okay. Right? And give me a good handshake like that. And now let's give a fist pound and a high five. And look in the camera and say, hi, Mom and Dad.
Hi, Mom and Dad.
And go Comets.
Go Comets.
All right. Have a great day.
Okay.
See you, Miguel. Thanks.
You're welcome.
Hi, Brenna. It's Brenna?
Yeah.
I'm Mr. Kendall. Nice to meet you. Have a seat right there, Brenna. What grade are you in?
I'm first.
You're in first grade?
Yeah.
And your teacher's name is?
Miss Dereka.
Miss Dereka. And what does she teach you in first grade?
Well, we're learning about frogs.
You're learning about frogs? So maybe some science in first grade. So tell me one unique thing about frogs.
Well, their tail don't fall off. It grows into their skin.
Oh, does it really? And then what happens?
Well, and then they turn into an adult frog.
An adult frog. Very interesting. And then we use them for...
Well... I don't know why we use them with the frog.
Not just for frog legs, which are not as tasty as chicken wings, you think? Probably not. Anyway, so other than studying about frogs in class, in Mrs. Dereka's class, what else do you do there?
Well, we have free choice, and it's really, really fun.
Free choice. So what do you choose to do in a free choice?
Well, usually I choose to do puzzles, but some of them are usually gone, but... So I usually sometimes do a thing where we write letters. It's called a writing center.
A writing center. You are a very sharp young lady. You know that? Very smart. You probably have some fantastic grades. How'd you like getting that new report card this year?
Good.
Seeing those A's on there. Wasn't that cool? Did you put it on the refrigerator?
Yeah.
Did you really?
Well, my mom still has it.
Oh, that's good. I know she was... probably pretty excited about your progress in school, right?
Yeah.
So, after you go to Kroll Elementary School and you go to middle school and high school, you probably go to college?
Probably.
Okay, and what do you think you'll probably do after college?
Well, this is what I really want to be when I grow up. I want to be a singer.
You want to be a singer?
Because I love to sing.
You love to sing, and you're really excited about being a singer.
Yeah, and I like to be on TV, too, like just now.
Like just now, being on TV. So what's your favorite TV show?
Wheel of Fortune.
Wheel of Fortune is your favorite TV show. Do they sing on Wheel of Fortune?
No.
Oh, okay. But you know some shows where people sing.
Yeah.
Well, let's see. Should we give you an opportunity to sing now? Because you can if you want.
Okay.
Okay, what do you want to sing?
At the Coffee's Bar.
Excuse me?
I learned this one from ballerina class.
Okay, I'm ready. 1, 2, 3.
Come along and follow me to the bottom of the sea. We'll join in the jamboree at the Coffee's Bar.
That is awesome. Great job. So a future American Idol for Brenna, right?
I'm going to be in recital soon.
You're going to be in recital soon?
Yeah, because I'm starting my songs. And when we start songs, we usually start the dresses and stuff.
Okay. And how are good grades going to help you reach the goals that you have in becoming a good singer?
Well, because you have to practice.
You have to practice. And that's kind of like homework. That's what homework is, right?
Yeah, just like practice. You have to practice really, really, really hard until you get it.
Exactly. And that's what you do in school every day?
Well, I don't do that in school, but I do kind of sing in my mind sometimes.
Okay. No, but I mean, do you use that same philosophy in school?
Yeah.
You really work hard and practice on all your subjects so you can get it, and that's how you maintain good grades?
Yeah.
So is that what you would tell other kids that are watching?
Yeah, because
Practice is important.
But sometimes people tell me to stop, but I don't really matter because they're not the boss of me, and because I want to practice so I can be good when I grow up.
Oh, okay. Very good. All right. Well, you're probably going to make a lot of money being a singer.
Yeah.
How much do you think?
1,000.
1,000? What are you going to do with all that money?
Spend it for my grandma.
Spend it on grandma, somebody you love, right? That's good. So let's say if somebody gave you $1,000,
yeah,
and they said, Brenna, I want you to buy a gift for Crawl Elementary School, something that all the kids in the school can use, what would you buy?
Well, I would, if they wanted to snow, I would get a snow machine.
Okay, maybe a snow machine. What else? Anything else?
Well, I could, if they don't have that, if they don't only have one pencil left, like if all of them broke and there's only one more left and no one can use except the teacher, I would get like 1,000 of them.
1,000 pencils, very good.
And that would cost $1,000 probably.
Right, for 1,000 pencils? Interesting. Now, what's the best thing about Crawl Elementary School?
That my teacher is great, and I just been waiting to be on TV all my life, and that's my dream.
Okay, and we're gonna help you reach that goal, and you reached it pretty good today. You did a fantastic job.
Yeah.
Please keep up doing a good job in school, okay, and help Mr. Director out every day by staying focused and being ready to learn, and being responsible, being ready, right, Brenna? You did a great job singing. Thanks for, you know what, you're the first person that had the opportunity to sing on Mr. Kendall's Corner. So that's kind of cool, isn't it? So make sure you watch us on CPHS6, where we showcase kids with talent, the brightest and best students in the Port Huron Area School District. Okay? So look in the camera right now. Let's get some flair to it. And say, hi, Mom and Dad, first.
Hi, Mom and Dad, if you're watching TV 6.
And la, 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 la.
La, 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 la.
All right. And go Comets.
Go Comets.
Okay. Let's get you out of here back to class. And you're on your way.
One more. That's it.
Great job, Brenna. Nice to meet you, too,
job.
Okay?
Great job.
That's better.
One more. That's it.
Just here for the pizza.
All right, listen, this is what we're going to do, guys. Come over here.
How about
we get two sit
right
and two stand, maybe?
Okay.
Here, we're going to have Kayliana. Kayliana here.
Oh, there's a bench right there.
Yep, we'll have them all on the bench.
Okay, here, go ahead and get down, Kayliana.
Exactly.
Oh, yeah, I'll sit on the bench, too.
There you guys go.
Sorry.
Here.
How's everybody doing today?
Good.
You guys doing good?
We have Kayliana.
Sit down a little bit, Kayliana.
Kayliana, Antonio.
Antonio.
Cohen. Bailey. And Bailey.
And Bailey. Can you guys scoot down and I'll sit next to you, Bailey? Or should I sit in between them?
Between.
No. Nope. You want to be at the
end. In the end. Okay. First of all, my name is Mr. Kendall. You guys know what I do? Hello, how are you? Good. How are you, Antonio?
Good.
Okay, let's go through everybody's names again. I'm Mr. Kendall.
Kendall.
And this is?
Bailey.
And this is?
Cohen.
Cohen and?
Antonio.
Antonio. And on the end?
Kayliana.
Kayliana. And what grade are you guys in?
First grade.
All of you guys are in first grade?
Yeah.
Wow. You have the same teacher?
Yeah.
Mrs.
Dereka. Mrs. Dereka, I'm hearing some fantastic things about Mrs. Dereka, but starting with Bailey, I'm going to have you tell me one good thing about Mrs. Dereka's class. Ready? Here's the microphone. Ready, go.
She's nice.
She's nice. What else? by the way, Cohen, you're just here for the pizza, right?
No, he loves pizza.
And he loves pizza. So what? What's good about Mrs. Dureka's class, though?
She gives out copying goods on a day when everyone hasn't got their card flipped.
All right, but she acknowledges good work by her students, right? Antonio?
That she lets us get books.
And you get books? Kaliana?
She lets us do free choice.
Okay, free choice. So, let's go with this then. Starting with you, Kaliana. If I gave you free choice right now, and you had to choose between math, reading, or writing, and we're going to do a center, which one would you pick?
Reading.
Antonio, what would you pick? Math, reading, or writing? Math, reading, or writing?
Writing.
You would write. What would you do, Cohen?
Write.
But you want some pizza next to you while you write, right?
Yeah.
Because you're here for the pizza. Bailey, what about you?
Math.
Okay. All of you guys like math?
Yeah.
Everybody likes to read stories in class?
I do.
You do? Okay.
Pizza today.
You ate pizza today too? What about Cohen? What's your favorite book?
Green Eggs and Ham.
Green Eggs and Ham. Sam, I am. I do not eat them. Green Eggs and Ham. Right? Mm-hmm. That book. What about you, Bailey?
David Goes to School. And what's
that story about?
When David's he goes Christmas. To school and he beats bad.
David does what?
Christmas.
David has Christmas at school?
No, at his house.
At his house. Interesting. Okay, now it's your turn, Antonio. What's your favorite book?
I like shark books.
You like shark books. What's so interesting about sharks?
That they eat bit.
I thought you were going to say they eat people. But they eat other fish. Very good. Kaliana.
They could try to eat a... Wait, I know a book. I saw this movie on the computer and I have that book. And it's called Zebra Drowns Lion.
Wow, okay. Kaliana, what's your favorite book? Have you read a nice book in the library or in Mrs. Dureka's classroom recently?
Frogs.
Frogs? You like the books about frogs?
Frogs and toads and mermaids and princesses.
Frogs, toads, mermaids, and princesses. That's interesting. What do they all have in common?
Well, two reasons that I like frogs and toads books is because we have them at classroom and we always read them sometimes and we're learning about frogs.
And you're learning about frogs for your science projects, huh?
And toads.
And toads. Well, great. You guys are doing a great job. Now, I got one final question. And I'm not going to ask you where the pizza is because Cohen's still looking for the pizza. But what do you want to be when you grow up, Bailey?
A vet.
Veterinarian. Cohen?
A firefighter.
Firefighter. Antonio?
A king frog.
You want to be a what?
A king frog.
You grow up?
Yep.
What do king frogs do? How are you going to make money?
They hop and they just...
Oh, he's being silly. What about you, Kaliana? What do you want to be when you grow up?
A princess and a movie star.
A princess and a movie star. And all of you guys are going to make some good choices to meet your goals, right? Every day, right, Antonio?
Yep, I'm going to be a baseball player, actually.
Baseball player.
And I'm going to play princesses and mermaids.
Very good. Now, let's say this. So you're going to finish doing a good job in school this year. Mm-hmm. So you can go to college one day, 10, 12 years from now.
I'm going to college.
Oh, yes, you are. You don't have a choice,
nope,
right?
Nope.
That's right.
Nope.
And
I'm not going to college.
Let's say you had some money to help out kids at Craw Elementary School. And you had enough money to buy one gift for the whole school. What would that be?
I would.
What would you buy, Kaliana?
I would surprise them about the whole entire school and everything.
Oh, that's your plan. What about you, Tonio? What's one thing that can help every kid in the building?
Frogs.
Frogs? Frogs? Yes. He's a frog man.
No,
Owen, what about you?
No.
I call 13 frogs.
Get lots and more books for the library.
Very good. Good answer. Bailey? Anything? Still thinking about it? All right. Keep up the good work in school. Keep doing a good job for Mrs. Dereka and your principal. And her name is?
Mrs. Gibson.
Great job, Bailey. All right. Look in the camera, everybody. And say, hi, Mom and Dad.
Hi, Mom and Dad.
And go Comets.
Go Comets.
All right. Wave. And Owen, now say, where's the pizza?
Where's the pizza?
I'm here for the pizza.
I'm here for the pizza.
All right. Have a great day, guys.
Okay, guys. Let's head back, okay?
All right. We're going to get to the last part where you sign off.
Oh.
Yes.
Nice job, guys.
Want me to stay on the bench?
Stay on the bench.
All right. Are we going to do this on one show, or are you going to do two versions for your school because it's so long?
It's going to be one show. It's going to go.
Give me a countdown.
Yep.
Okay.
Check out the shot.
Tie good.
Tie's good. Father's good. Good. Okay. Yep, that's good. If you can push your watch back or get your sleeve to cover it because it's shining right in the camera.
How's
that's
that?
Good. That's good.
Good.
Okay.
You want me to just do the final outro?
Yep,
don't say nothing about the. Okay.
Okay, and 5, 4, 3, 2.
And remember, the Port Huron Area School District is a dynamic teaching and learning community shaping students to be responsible global citizens. Thank you for watching and have a great evening.
5, 4, 3, 2, 1. We're clear.
Good enough, Ed, or no?
I just have one more. Just saying something about the fact of hope you had fun.
Yeah, let's do that.
Today, and then remember that, and then go into this field, and
okay.
Then keep your eyes at that camera. Don't
until
look
he counts counts over.
Yeah.
Okay.
Okay. 5, 4, 3, 2.
I certainly hope you enjoyed the fun we had today, working with kindergarten students from Indian Woods Elementary School and Crawl Elementary. They're excited about their learning. They're enthusiastic. And they are definitely some awesome students. So we got to continue to take care of them. So remember, the Port Huron Area School District is a dynamic teaching and learning community shaping students to be responsible global citizens.
5, 4, 3, 2, 1. We're clear?
Natural.
That was better?
Perfect.
Booyah!
Perfect.
Ed, that was...
it's draining, isn't it?
Oh, my God.
That...
I'll never forget my man Miguel. Give me another word that starts with SH.
Yeah, I know. I know, and I was like, whoa.
Oh, shit. I just like.